Thai fried rice without the chicken. You can add chicken and beef or fish if you wanted to make it with meat. So I have only vegetables. I've already chopped the vegetables. Green peppers, red peppers, onion, and celery. Well, those are my vegetables. Here, I have chopped garlic. And normally, this is where I would also have chopped jalapenos.
You could chop some pepper.
I'm not doing the jalapenos because the chickpeas, I mean the lentils are hot. So this is a little bit mild. My sauces, I have soy sauce, just a little bit, plum sauce, oyster sauce, sesame seed, fish sauce, Worcestershire sauce, and a little olive oil. And I've already pre-cooked the rice. And normally you cook the rice a day before you chop your vegetables. For some reason, they say the rice is better the second day after it's been in the refrigerator. But I can't sense the difference. Okay, so I got my wok. And I add a little oil, about 2 tablespoons. I washed my hand before. So I brown my onions, chopped celery, chopped garlic. While that's going, I mix up my little sauces. The main one is this one, the oyster sauce.
Really?
And I use about 3 tablespoons. It doesn't have to be exact. And I'm not a favorite of fish sauce. I only put a little bit. Worcestershire sauce, just out of habit. A little sesame seed. This turns your rice kind of brown or yellow. But the rice is already yellow because I use saffron.
Mmm, nice.
Did I use this one? Ooh. Just a little, this one. And for some reason, they want you to add sugar to it. Anybody know why?
I think it makes it caramelize a little bit.
Oh, okay. Mm-hmm.
And I usually see that in Thai recipes, not that I cook it very much. So.
So our garlic should be nice and burned by now. Because it doesn't take the garlic long. Do you smell it?
Yeah, come over and take a picture of the garlic. The garlic.
And normally you would have the chopped jalapenos in there.
Uh-huh,
yeah. And now I dump all of these in. And I like the red pepper because it adds, nice color to it. So I let them kind of cook a little bit. Because the way I cook this recipe, the vegetables are crunchy, when you eat it. They won't be real soft. And you can add those packages of frozen vegetables, carrots, peas, and stuff like that. But I find when you do that, it adds liquid to this, and it makes the rice kind of soggy or lumpy, whereas this way the rice will be kind of separated. I use a cup and 3/4 or a little
of water.
Of water. Just a little. I think I'm going to turn this up a little bit. So that's going.
Okay, can I turn off for a minute?
And
vegetables, yep. Looking lovely.
And now I'm going to add my little sauce to it. But you see how it's kind of dry and doesn't, mm-hmm. You don't have a whole lot of liquid floating around.
Mm-hmm. Which one? It's interesting that you don't need that much sauce for all those vegetables.
Yeah. Because the rice is flavored.
I got
you
it.
Can eat the rice by itself. The rice has water, oil, or butter, or margarine, garlic powder, black pepper, bouillon, chicken or beef.
Right.
That's my salt. And then I add. The one with the saffron.
Got it.
And that makes my rice look like that.
Beautiful. That rice. Mm-hmm. That's beautiful. Look at that. Gorgeous.
That's rice. Good.
So it's, and then I just and take a look how it blends in with this.
It's gonna be so pretty.
Break it up.
Jasmine.
Huh?
Jasmine.
Yeah.
What kind
of
egg?
Basmati.
Yeah. But you probably could use any rice. For some reason, it all tastes about the same.
Mm-hmm.
Take a look at it inside.
Oh. Crusty part's the best part. Yeah, spicy, huh? Yeah, good. Yeah, I do too.
I just, it's so different.
It's an experiment. That's
it's
why
a little
I bought
sweet,
it.
But.
Well, it's a chutney, so it's sweet and, yeah, it has sugar and. Sweet. That's just sweet, yeah. I made another one that had enough cut pepper in it. I'll make some more. Yeah, I was going for peach jalapeno, but I didn't put enough jalapeno in it, or the one that I had was not.
Oh, you made these?
Yeah. Look how pretty. Now you've got enough for days. Oh, it smells really good.
And you don't add any more seasoning, so it's already seasoned.
Mm-hmm.
But you can imagine if you have the chicken.
Right.
I would add the chicken when the vegetables are cooking so it can absorb some of that seasoning.
Do you ever add a scrambled egg or anything like that?
You can, but I'm not an egg person, so I'm prejudiced. I leave things out that I don't like. So actually, on all recipes, I read through it and take everything I don't like and then out.
I'm with you.
And then most of the people can't eat the jalapenos, so I end up leaving the jalapenos out. Or making the dish twice, or half of it with jalapenos.
Right.
Yeah, no.
This is my, you want to try this? This is my ginger tea with orange and whatever. Good?
Okay, it's finished.
It's so good. Yay!
I love orange and ginger.
Tiene mountinga, la negra Tomasa, mira, te digo que la negra Tomasa, te digo que lo es linga.
Kiribu mantica,
kiribu, 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 mandi, mantinga, mantinga, mira, cuidado, ya tuve como me dice la negra.